Jarenlang leefde hij in het oerwoud in het Afrikaanse Congo op zoek naar chimpansees. En daar vond hij ze ook, de primatoloog Clive Hicks. Hij ontdekte een enorme chimpanseepopulatie met meer dan 100.000 apen, zelfs de grootste ter wereld. En dat was dus een unieke ontdekking. Maar die chimpansee-leefgemeenschap wordt nu bedreigd door de oprukkende goud- en diamantindustrie.
Mijn werk is in de Congo met de chimpansen.
Ja,
in Congo. De chimpansen kapot, de slok.
Clive Hicks raakt niet over ze uitgepraat. De primatoloog bestudeerde jarenlang chimpansees in het wild. Nu is hij terug in Nederland om hier aan de Universiteit van Amsterdam te promoveren op zijn favoriete dier, de chimpansee.
Well, chimpanzees, as I'm sure you know, are our closest living relatives, along with bonobos. So they're actually very close to humans, and not just genetically, but also behaviorally, culturally. In fact, my study is on chimpanzee cultures.
Ja, u hoort het goed. Ook apen hebben cultuur. Cleef vond in Noord-Congo een enorm leefgebied van chimpansees die volgens hem allemaal dezelfde gewoontes hebben.
Just like with humans. Our cultures vary from place to place. A lot of it, you know, we consider is tied to language. But if you look at, say, Chinese people, a lot of Chinese people eat with chopsticks. We eat with forks here. Well, chimpanzees have the same kind of cultural variation in how they find food, with different kinds of tools that are used in different places in Africa. So it's really, we've just scratched the surface of chimpanzee cultural variation across Africa.
There's a massive gap in our knowledge about chimpanzees, and that's right here in the center, in the northern Congo, and it's probably the biggest population left on the planet.
These are African giant snails, and I brought these back from the Democratic Republic of Congo in Beli, where I was working, in the Beli area. And the chimpanzees here, they have a smashing culture. So they pick up these snails, they also pick up termite mounds, and they smash them open, as you can see, on buttresses. Now these snails are available to be eaten in lots of other forests in Africa, but the chimps don't touch them. They also never smash open a termite mound. And this is a chimpanzee culture that we've discovered. And in fact, it's probably the biggest chimpanzee culture yet to be seen in Africa.
It's very shaky, I know, but there's a youngster sitting here. You see the youngster's shoulder watching the adult male as he dips for driver ants. You can see the adult male's head here. You can actually see the adult male transferring the ants from the hole into his mouth. But this is crucial footage because it shows the process through which these material cultures are spread through the generations. Youngsters paying very close attention to what the older chimpanzees are doing. Now we know something a lot more about how they're actually doing it here in this area. But for these longer tools, like this, these are used for another species of much more aggressive ant. And we haven't unfortunately captured them using these tools on film yet. And so we don't know why they're making them so big. These are the biggest that we've seen so far in Africa.
Cleef maakte verschillende expedities in dit diepe, moeilijk begaanbare bos. Hij kwam er heel veel chimpansees tegen. Goed nieuws dus. Maar inmiddels is de organisatie waar hij jarenlang voor werkte niet meer actief in de regio.
The Beli is a domaine de chasse. It's a protected region. And we were, the Wasmuth Wildlife Foundation was there to basically help the people by buying their coffee at high prices in exchange for helping them protect the wildlife. Well, unfortunately, the chiefs got a better offer and basically invited a large number of gold miners into this pristine, you know, domaine de chasse. And we got evidence that they're killing elephants now, that they're killing chimps. So we could no longer collaborate.
Her mother had been killed by a pack of dogs a few days earlier, and she'd been captured and brought into the village to be sold. And like I said, we've seen 34 of these orphans in the time that I was there, and also 31 cadavers. There is a real massacre of chimpanzees happening, and these orphans end up living alone in tiny huts in mud. They usually die of illness. It's just a real tragedy that's happening there.
Op dit moment is er dus geen enkele organisatie in de regio die de apen beschermt. De primatoloog maakt zich ernstige zorgen, want volgens hem bevat de streek een schat aan informatie die niet verloren mag gaan.
My main argument is that the area of Beli Owelle in northern Congo presents us one of our
best and last opportunities to save our sister species, the chimpanzee, in their natural habitat. This is the biggest population, part of the biggest population left on the planet. They have a megaculture. When you go there, you're actually able to see chimpanzees as they probably lived throughout most of their evolutionary history before Homo sapiens came in and started ruining everything. But that's going to go very quickly if we don't move in, get more researchers out there, get more conservationists out there. I'm trying to inspire people about this megaculture because it's really amazing that you can travel 400 kilometers from one patch of forest to the other, from one area of the forest to the other, and find the chimps are doing the same thing throughout the entire region.
Na het afronden van zijn studie hoopt Cleve weer terug te kunnen. Hoe, weet hij nog niet. Ook hoopt hij dat de kleine, geredde chimpanseetjes uiteindelijk in een veilige opvang terechtkomen. En niet, zoals sommige Congolese bestuurders nu willen, in deze dierentuin.
I have my friends Laura and Adam are out there now looking after the 5 chimpanzees that we have confiscated. We didn't buy these chimpanzees. You know, that's a very important thing to... We didn't give any gift. Here's me... this is my friend Chef Mange. He's wearing a leopard skin hat, but he's actually a good man. He doesn't want to see all of his chimpanzees eaten and taken away because he knows it's going to be a benefit for him in the future. So he agreed to give me this chimpanzee who would have died otherwise, and we are caring for this chimpanzee in our sanctuary in Akedi right now. But it's real important we get these chimpanzees out of Akedi and to an official sanctuary. This area, you're not seeing child soldiers, you're not seeing the horrible effects of civil war, you're not seeing the forest gone up in smoke and all the animals. It's still savable for humans and other species. It's not too late.
Goud- en diamanthandelaren zijn nu de enigen die nog in de streek geïnteresseerd lijken te zijn. Maar Cleve hoopt dat er binnenkort ook weer internationale organisaties en wetenschappers in Billy te vinden zullen zijn.
We can't protect every patch of forest in that area. And in some places it's legal to mine for gold and diamonds. But what we need is to enforce help the Congolese government enforce the already protected areas like Bili and Ruby Tele, which are near where I work. They're not being protected right now. They're being overrun by gold miners. We need to save part of it for the future, at least.
Okay, this is the situation this chimp is in. Not too good, huh? And so they're gonna open up the string that he's tied to. Hey, little guy, Kigoma.
Met deze reportage uit het Afrikaanse Congo zijn we aan het einde gekomen van één vandaag. Op deze zender gaan de collega's van het Sportjournaal verder. Wij zijn er gewoon morgen weer, dus wat ons betreft graag tot dan.